will attempt to move the political battleground to Scotland. He'll be visiting Aberdeenshire, where he, we understand, will be announcing over £51 million of extra funding for farmers in Scotland. It's very much him wanting to see that as a Prime Minister, he is a defender of the Union, the United Kingdom. It's a very disunited kingdom. And we see the divisions. They were perfectly illustrated yesterday when we got the surprise resignation of his younger brother, Joe Johnson, Minister for Universities, who in a tweet said that he had found it really, he was torn between family loyalty and the national interest, and he said it's an unresolvable tension and time for others to take on my roles as MP and Minister, hashtag over and out. But of course it's not over and out for, well, it might be politically for Joe Johnson, but it's not over and out yet at all for the Prime Minister, who is, although embattled, having lost key votes this week in Parliament, first, of course, losing control of parliamentary business, and, of course, this Brexit bill, tying his hand and wanting a three-month extension, that rebel alliance of the opposition. And we think that, well, it will go through the House of Lords by 5 p.m. London time today, be then again go back to the House of Commons on Monday. And what we learnt yesterday is that we will get another attempt from the government and the Prime Minister, because he is set on having that early general election on Tuesday the 15th of October. But although he considers in Downing Street that yesterday was their first day in this campaign, the problem is he doesn't have a confirmation at all, nor does he look like getting that confirmation or approval of the two-thirds of MPs on Monday.
And Benedict Pavia reporting there.